I can hear you say that I'm the one. At times I feel your lips press close to mine, but what good has that dreaming done?
Welcome everyone, I am your host, Brooke Palmer, and you have arrived at the Antique Music Mall. We have some great tunes to share with you today. And do I see Philip with a microphone behind that glass partition?
Hello, Brooke. No big surprise. I always have a microphone, just in case. Not that I expect any problems. You are the consummate professional.
As usual, Philip has handed me songs to play, expecting me to know what they have in common from 50 years ago. Even my parents weren't born 50 years ago. But that's okay. This is not only an entertainment show, it is also an educational one, and this first song is called Gigi, by Louis Jordan. But isn't he an actor, and not really a singer, Philip?
Good, Brooke, that is certainly true. Actors often take their hand at singing, even though they're not really singers. Marlon Brando did it in Guys and Dolls. Clint Eastwood did it in Paint Your Wagon. Even Ryan Gosling did it in La La Land.
But was it a hit song for Louis Jordan?
Not really. Vic Damone had a top 100 hit with this song in 1958. And Les Baxter and his orchestra had an instrumental hit with Gigi in 1953. But not Louis Jordan.
Knowing you, you must have your reasons for picking Louis Jordan. So I'm just going to play it. Here is Gigi.
There's sweeter music when she speaks, isn't there? A different bloom about her cheeks, isn't there? Could I be wrong? Could it be so? Oh, where did Gigi go? Gigi, am I a fool without a mind? Or have I merely been too blind to realize? Oh, Gigi, why you've been growing up before my eyes. Gigi, you're not at all that funny, awkward little girl I knew. Oh no, overnight there's been a breathless change in you. Oh, Gigi, while you were trembling on the brink, was I out yonder somewhere blinking at a star? Oh, Gigi, have I been standing up too close or back too far? When did your sparkle turn to fire and your warmth become desire? Oh, what miracle has made you the way you are? Gigi. Gigi. Not to have seen the change in you. Oh, Gigi, while you were trembling on the brink, was I out yonder somewhere blinking at a star? Oh, Gigi, have I been standing up too close or back too far? When did your sparkle turn to fire and your warmth become desire? Oh, what miracle has made you the way you are?
This next song was recorded by Frank Sinatra and a bunch of kids. It's called High Hopes, and it is the only version of this song to hit Billboard's Top 100. It peaked at number 30 and spent over 4 months on the chart in 1959.
That's right, Brooke. And this song was first recorded by Eddie Hodges a few weeks before Old Blue Eyes made it a hit. 10-year-old Eddie Hodges split the $25,000 grand prize with future astronaut and American hero Major John Glenn as his teammate after they successfully appeared on the popular TV game show Name That Tune in 1957. Eddie Hodges had 21 acting credits to his name, but he eventually dropped out of performing and became a mental health counselor in his native Mississippi.
According to the John F. Kennedy Presidential Library and Museum, Mr. Sinatra sang this song during John Kennedy's successful 1960 presidential run, and it became the president's campaign song. The song was written by Jimmy Van Heusen and Sammy Kahn. And Eddie Hodges did not sing on Frank Sinatra's single of this song.
Just what makes that little old ant think he'll move that rubber tree plant? Anyone knows an ant can't move a rubber tree plant.
But he's got high hopes. He's got high hopes. He's got high apple pie in the sky hopes.
So anytime you're getting low, instead of letting go, just remember that ant. Oops, there goes another rubber tree plant.
Oops, there goes another rubber tree plant.
Oops, there goes another rubber tree plant. Once there was a silly old ram, thought he'd punch a hole in a dam. No one could make that ram scram. He kept butting that dam, 'cause he had high hopes.
He had high hopes.
He had high apple pie in the sky hopes. So anytime you're feeling bad, instead of feeling sad, just remember that ram. Oops, there goes a billion kilowatt dam.
Oops, there goes a billion kilowatt dam.
Oops, there goes a billion kilowatt dam. Another problem kerplop.
Oops, there goes another problem kerplop.
Oops, there goes another problem kerplop.
Kerplop!
Never on Sunday was written by Greek composer Manos Hadjidakis. It was first released in Greek, sung by Melina Mercouri. That was in May 1960. 2 months after the Melina Mercouri release, Don Costa came out with a top 20 version that peaked at number 19. That was a terrific rendition of Never on Sunday with a Greek island sound backed up with the chorus. But we have decided to feature the highest charting version of this song by the Chordettes with English lyrics by Billy Town. The Chordettes' version entered Billboard's top 100 the next year in June 1961. This song spent 3 months on the pop chart and peaked at number 13. Bum, 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 bum.
Oh, you can kiss me on a Monday. A Monday, a Monday is very, very good. Or you can kiss me on a Tuesday. A Tuesday, a Tuesday. In fact, I wish you would. Or you can kiss me on a Wednesday. Never, never on a Sunday, a Sunday, a Sunday, 'cause that's my day of rest. Most any day, you can be my guest. Any day you say, but my day of rest. Just name the day that you like the kiss me on a cool day, a hot day, a wet day, whichever one you choose. Or try to kiss me on a gray day, a May day, a pay day, and see if I refuse. And if you make it on a bleak day, a freak day, a weak day, well, you can be my guest. But never, never on a Sunday, a Sunday. Kiss me on a weekday, a weekday, a weekday's the day to be my guest. But never, never on a Sunday, a Sunday, a Sunday, 'cause that's my day of rest. But never, never on a Sunday, a Sunday, a Sunday, 'cause that's my day of rest.
Brooke, our next selection is a very famous song called Moon River. I know that you've heard of that one. My dilemma was choosing a version to play. There are several to choose from. In case you didn't know, we played Moon River by Audrey Hepburn on our sister podcast, Thematic Nostalgia, show number 53. And then again, we played Henry Mancini's version in Thematic Nostalgia, show number 5. So I did what I always do. I checked Billboard's Top 100 and found that Jerry Butler's version basically did as well as Henry Mancini's version. They both peaked at number 11 in 1961. And it's amazing how close they were on a variety of different charts. It was like they were twin songs, but they were different versions. But both are great, and some people think Jerry Butler had the definitive version. So here we go, Moon River, by Jerry Butler.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday. Dreammaker, you old heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters world. There's such a lot of world to see. We're after the same rainbows, waiting round the bend. Huckleberry friend, Moon River, and me.
Days of Wine and Roses, by Andy Williams, peaked at number 26 in 1963. This version charted slightly higher than the Henry Mancini version, which we actually played on Thematic Nostalgia, show number 5. There was also a bubbling under version of this song by Pat Boone, in this same year. But the thing that these five songs have in common is not dependent on which version we use. The songs themselves share a special distinction with each other. I will let you know what that something is after we play this next song by Mr. Andy Williams.
The days of wine and roses laugh and run away like a child at play through a meadowland toward a closing door, a door marked nevermore that wasn't there before. Filled with memories of the golden smile that introduced me to the days of wine and roses and introduced me to the days of wine and roses and you.
These first five tunes were all Academy Award winners for Best Song, starting with the year 1958. It is the songwriters that actually received the Little Golden Oscar. But the songs themselves will always hold the honor of being Oscar-winning songs, regardless of who performs them. In fact, there have been several performers that have devoted entire albums to these songs. Eddie Fisher, Connie Francis, and even British pianist Frank Chaxfield, to name a few, have released LPs of Oscar-winning songs. Feel free to check out Thematic Nostalgia shows number 2 and 36 to hear the Oscar-winning songs from earlier years, going back to the first year that Best Song was a category, in 1934. In 1958, Gigi won Best Song at the Oscars from the movie Gigi, written by Frederick Lowe, with lyrics by Alan J. Lerner. In 1959, Jimmy Van Heusen won the Oscar for High Hopes, along with lyricist Sammy Kahn. And that was from the movie, A Hole in the Head. In 1960, from the movie Never on Sunday, the song of the same name won an Oscar for Manos Hadzidakis. He was widely considered one of Greece's greatest composers. Henry Mancini, along with lyricist Johnny Mercer, won back-to-back Oscars for Moon River from Breakfast at Tiffany's in 1961, and The Days of Wine and Roses from 1962, from the movie of the same name. And that brings us to 1963. In this year, Call Me Irresponsible won another Best Song Oscar for Jimmy Van Heusen and Sammy Kahn. This would be the fourth and last Best Song Oscar for Sammy Kahn, three of which were with composer Jimmy Van Heusen. His first Oscar was for Three Coins in a Fountain, with composer Jules Stein. And likewise, Jimmy Van Heusen won four Best Song Oscars. Mr. Van Heusen's first Oscar was in 1944 for the song Swinging on a Star, made famous by Bing Crosby. There were two top 100 versions of Call Me Irresponsible that year. One was by Frank Sinatra and one was by Jack Jones. The Jack Jones version did slightly better, peaking at number 73. This song is from the movie, Popper's Delicate Condition, starring Jackie Gleason. And away we go.
Call me unreliable, throwing undependable too. Do predictable, tell me I'm impractical, rainbows I'm inclined to pursue. Call
Brooke, in 1964, a song from Mary Poppins won the Academy Award for the Best Song. Did you see that movie? It's pretty much a classic for little kids, especially English kids, I would imagine.
No, Philip. Somehow, I missed that one. But I did see Mary Poppins Returns, starring Emily Blunt and Lin-Manuel Miranda, from a few years ago.
Of course you did. Richard and Robert Sherman were prolific writers, mostly of Disney Studios. So it's not surprising to learn that the Sherman brothers wrote more motion picture musical song scores than any other songwriting team in film history.
I am certain that I would recognize some of their songs. Could you hum a few bars of one of their hits?
Better than that, Brooke. Here is Chim Chim Cheree. Now, Dick Van Dyke sang this song in the movie. You can check out Thematic Nostalgia, show number 33, if you want to hear that one. Dick Van Dyke's version of this song bubbled under the top 100 in 1965, and so did a version by Burl Ives. But this next song is from the new Christy Minstrel.
Strung, a chimney sweeps on the bottommost rung. Though I spend my time in the ashes and smoke, in this whole wide world there's no happier bloke.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree, a chimney sweeps lucky as lucky can be.
Smoke is all billowed and curled, twixt pavement and stars is a chimney sweet world.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree, a chimney sweet lucky as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo, good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you.
Gables and rooftops become Taj Mahals, and blimey, chimneys are great Chinese walls.
The pillars of Hercules loom left and right. The Sphinx, the Acropolis, ooh, what a sight.
The Shadow of Your Smile, also known as the love theme from The Sandpiper, was written by Johnny Mandel, with the lyrics by Paul Francis Webster. The song was introduced in the 1965 film, The Sandpiper, with a trumpet solo by Jack Sheldon. It later became a minor hit for Tony Bennett. Johnny Mandel arranged and conducted Mr. Bennett's version as well. The song won the Grammy Award for Song of the Year and the Academy Award for Best Original Song. In 2004, this song finished at number 77 in the American Film Institute's poll of the top tunes in American cinema. There have been two charting versions of this song in the top 100. The one alluded to, by Tony Bennett, and this slightly higher charting version, by Boots Randolph. Boots Randolph was an American musician, best known for his 1963 saxophone hit Yakety Sax, which became Benny Hill's signature tune. Boots Randolph's instrumental version of The Shadow of Your Smile peaked at number 93 and remained on the pop chart for 3 weeks toward the end of 1966 into 1967. Both versions of this song were much more successful on the adult contemporary chart.
Born Free was the Academy Award-winning song from 1966. It nearly missed qualifying for the Oscar because the producers of the movie Born Free thought the song was uncommercial, and they deleted the song from the film's premiere held in London. Matt Munro, who had recorded the song for the movie, was not happy the song was cut. When Matt Munro informed Don Black, the song's lyricist, that the song was eliminated, they successfully lobbied the producers to restore the song to the film. Matt Munro's version of Born Free did appear in the end credits of the film in a shortened form, but this was enough to qualify Born Free for the Oscar, and the rest is history.
Philip, it may surprise you, but I know all about Born Free. It was written by John Barry, an English composer of many film scores, including 11 James Bond films. He also won 5 Academy Awards, himself. And lyricist Don Black was also English. Even Matt Munro, who sang the song for the movie, was English. All Music has described Mr. Munro, as one of the most underrated pop vocalists of the 1960s.
Good for you, Brooke. You're becoming a pop music aficionado. We won't be playing Matt Monro's version here. It bubbled under the top 100 at number 126 for 1 week. The definitive version is by Roger Williams. That's the one most people know. That was a top 10 hit in 1966. The Antique Music Mall will play a terrific version instead by the R&B group called The Hesitations. And this version also did well. It was a top 40 hit on the pop chart, and it was number 4 on the R&B chart. And listen for that great baritone voice of George Scott. And there's a very sad story attached to this group. The group members and a couple of wives were in one car, and a band member had a gun with him to show the others. As that band member was about to put the gun away into the glove compartment, it went off. And prior to that, somebody had told a joke and everyone was laughing. Even George Scott, sitting in the front seat, was laughing along with everybody else. Scott had a smile on his face as they took him to the hospital. The shooting was deemed accidental, but George Scott was dead. The Hesitations disbanded after 1968, after this incident. But the Hesitations regrouped in 2006 with new members performing and recording once again.
The grass grows, born free to follow your heart. Live free,
and beauty surrounds you. The world still astounds you each time you look at a star. Go on and stay free. Let no walls divide you. You're free as the roaring tide, and there's no need to hide. I say I'm born free, and the life is worth living, but only worth living 'cause you.
Hallelujah.
Give me one chance.
Hallelujah.
Explain
hallelujah.
Something to you right now.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
This freedom thing
hallelujah.
That the Lord
hallelujah.
Gave us.
Hallelujah.
Remember,
hallelujah.
It's a thing that we
hallelujah.
Should check
hallelujah.
And love every day.
Born free.
Wow. I gotta
as
say
free
one thing for you right now. Somebody
as
tonight,
I'm
out in the cold. Chained up somewhere.
I said, I'm free.
Thank the Lord.
And
life is
let me
be free. Don't take it for granted, no. Thank the Lord that you can be born free.
Anthony Newley was an English actor, singer, songwriter, and filmmaker. He achieved success as a performer in such diverse fields as rock and roll, stage acting, and screen acting. As a singer, his recordings reached the United Kingdom Singles Chart on a dozen occasions between 1959 and 1962. This includes 2 number one hits. And here is another connection to English composer John Barry. Anthony Newley wrote the lyrics to Goldfinger. Mr. Newley was nominated for the Best Film Score Oscar in 1971 for Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. Anthony Newley was inducted into the Songwriters Hall of Fame in 1989. But next, he sings the Oscar-winning song from Dr. Doolittle. The song is Talk to the Animals, from 1967. The song was written by Leslie Bricus, who wrote many songs with Anthony Newley. But not this one. There are no top 100 versions of this song in America, but Mr. Newley's version is a classic non-Hot 100 hit, as listed by Joel Whitman.
If we could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting with a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting with a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. We would converse in polar bear and python, and we would curse in fluent kangaroo. If people asked us, can you speak a rhinoceros? We'd say, of course, Rhinoceros. Can't you? If we conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of all the things we could discuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us. If we consulted with quadrupeds, think what fun we'd have asking over crocodiles for tea. Or maybe lunch with two or three lions, walruses and sea lions. What a lovely place the world would be. We'd learn to speak in antelope and turtle. Our Pekingese would be extremely good. If we were asked to sing in hippopotamus, we'd say, why anonymous? And would. And I am sure every octopus, place and platypus certainly would see it as a plus. If we could walk with those animals, talk with those animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with those animals, and they could talk to us. We'd study every living creature's language, so we could speak to all of them on sight. If friends said, can you talk in crab or pelican? We'd say, like hell we can. And we'd be right. And if we all spoke like animals, who needs English? Gradually we'd drop it with no fuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could squeak and squawk and speak and talk to us.
That last one was interesting, Brooke. It's amazing how you always manage to inject some British personalities into the show. Did I not ask you to play Louis Armstrong's version of Talk to the Animals? I'm not complaining. Anthony Newley is terrific, but come on, Louis Armstrong. But I enjoyed your research about James Bond and Willy Wonka and that whole English connection. After all, the Oscars do try to showcase the best. We've had Best Picture winners from several countries throughout the world. Most recently, Coda was produced by a Frenchman, and 2 years ago, Parasite was a South Korean film, and the list goes on.
Philip, I am so glad that you were open-minded. That's why I keep coming back.
Maybe so, but you must admit, I pay you really well. I'll take the next song, Brooke. The song is Windmills of Your Mind, and this was an Oscar-winning song from 1968, and it came from the movie The Thomas Crown Affair. The original one, Brooke, not the one with Pierce Brosnan and Rene Russo. That was a remake in 1999. And I'm going to play the Jimmy Rogers version. If you don't know, Brooke, Jimmy Rogers had a number one hit with Honeycomb and plenty of other hits, mostly in the late 50s. Jimmy Rogers' version of Windmills of Your Mind bubbled under at number 123 in 1969, but it's still really good.
Sorry, Philip. I really wanted to play Dusty Springfield's version. That was a top 40 hit. I know how you love Billboard's top 40, especially from the 60s. Or, if you prefer, I can play Noel Harrison's version. He sang this song in the actual movie.
Brooke, these two singers that you selected, aren't they both from London, England?
That's true. But this has nothing to do with it.
Go ahead and play Dusty Springfield. I must admit, I've always liked Dusty. And since Michel Legrand from France wrote the song, we might as well keep the whole thing in Europe.
Round, like a circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning, on an ever-spinning wheel, like a snowball down a mountain, or a carnival balloon, like a carousel that's turning, running rings around the moon, like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face, and the world is like an apple whirling silently in space, like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind. Tunnel that you follow to a tunnel of its own, down a hollow to a cavern where the sun has never shone, like a door that keeps revolving in a half-forgotten dream, or the ripples from a pebble someone tosses in a stream, like a clock whose hands are sweeping past the minutes of its face, and the world is like an apple whirling silently in space, like the circles that you find in the wind. Keys that jingle in your pocket, words that jangle in your head. Why did summer go so quickly? Was it something that you said? Lovers walk along the shore and leave their footprints in the sand. Is the sound of distant drumming just the fingers of your pictures hanging in a hallway and the fragment of a song? Half-remembered names and faces, but to whom do they belong? When you knew that it was over, you were suddenly aware that the autumn leaves were turning to the color smile, like a wheel within a wheel, never ending or beginning, on an ever spinning wheel, as the images unwind, like the circles that you find in the windmills of your
It's time to say goodbye. But not before we play the last Oscar-winning song from the 1960s. In 1969, Burt Bacharach and Hal David took home Oscar for Raindrops Keep Falling on My Head, from Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. That song not only won the Oscar, it is also a Grammy Hall of Fame record. B.J. Thomas was getting over laryngitis when he recorded this song. It gave the song a raspy quality that the producers of the movie liked. 8 weeks later, Mr. Thomas recorded another version that was released as a single in October 1969. This version, with the famous horn solo added to the end, made number one in the United States the first week of 1970, and stayed there for 4 weeks. B.J. Thomas said, "I was in the right place, at the right time, and probably got their best song ever." And in case you are wondering, that picture of a building in the Antique Music Mall logo is the Santa Monica Civil Center. Most of the Academy Award shows during the 1960s were held there. If you haven't already, please subscribe to our show. And thanks for staying to the end. And for now, goodbye, Oscar.
Raindrops are falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun, and I said I didn't like the way he got things done. Sleeping on the job, those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying.